Maintenance Man fans, I'm going to be doing a video today on how to attach a 220 volt cord to the back of a stove. I have my 6-in-1 here. You just need to have a 1/4 inch hex head nut driver. I've got one of these clamps here for the cord and the cord itself. So what you're going to find on the back of your stove is going to be generally in the middle of an electric stove is some form of shroud that's going to need to come off, and that's where your 1/4 inch nut driver is going to come in handy. And generally there is one, maybe two, and sometimes it's a box that's down in the bottom left hand corner or right hand corner. Sometimes it's going to take a 5/16 nut driver. It could be any kind of shroud. This one is specifically a hot point, so they use this style. Just slip your clamp inside there to the best of your ability. And I'm going to use my screwdriver here to spread it back out so we can get the cord up through there. Just to widen that thing up. I slip the cord, all three leads, as they're called, up inside there. It wants to spin on me. Alright. Work them up through there until they are out. Now, what we're going to find in here is you're going to have your three wires that go up, red, white, and black. You're going to have three terminals down here on the bottom that connect to them. When you look at your cord, the middle one goes to the middle, right one goes to the right, left one goes to the left. On a dryer, not a dryer, on a stove. Sorry, that's what we're working on. All I'm going to do is take my hex head driver, 1/4 inch, or if you can see right here, they do have a Phillips available. And I'm on mine, I'm actually not going to take them out all the way. I'm going to take them out 75% of the way. And what this is going to do is it's going to allow me to slip these over there. You can see how the end of these has been chopped open. Sometimes they actually make them so that they are open like that. And you're just going to slip them. Let's see if I can get a close-up of this. You're just going to slip them right up on the back side like that. All three of them. It's fairly thick wire, so you're going to want to push really hard. And since I'm doing this one-handed, I'm going to do the first one and, sorry about that, tighten it down. Sorry for the poor quality of the video. My camera doesn't seem to want to focus very well. And I once again am doing this one-handed. That one's not gonna stay. I'm gonna get out my SOG multi-tool here. I'm gonna grab a hold of the bottom of that. Like I said, the wires are thick. You gotta really work them kind of hard. But there you go. Put your shroud back on. What I had here is that little tab right there. Make sure that the screw hole lines up there. And once you have battened down the hatches, you should be good to go. Stove cord installed. You should be able to just plug it right in. Be good to go. Thanks for watching The Maintenance Man. Don't forget to check me out on Facebook, www.facebook.com/askthemaintenanceman, and you will find my Maintenance Man how to. You can ask any question on there, post it, and I will answer as quickly as I possibly can. I've also got a website. It's askthemaintenanceman.webstarts.com. So you can check me out there. I've got some links to other YouTube videos, or you can just continue watching things here on YouTube. But anyway, have a great day.